विज्ञानी लक्षदा ज्ञान निरसुनिया विज्ञानी लक्षदा राघव सा धर्म जागो
लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु। May all the beings in the world be happy. This aspiration of universal welfare is called as dharma. And the culture of our nation, India, is based on this aspiration, this dharma. To our culture, Ayodhya is fountainhead. Sri Rama Janmabhoomi is the heart of our culture. Ayodhya is a pride of India. Mohenjo-daro is a pride of our nation, India. Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, their sites have to be preserved by the whole world. Whole world has a duty to preserve these sites because these are the oldest sites available in the world from archaeological point of view. If Harappa Mohenjo-daro sites are the oldest ones from archaeological point of view, Ayodhya is one of the oldest cities of the world in literature point of view. Ayodhya is mentioned, nay, described in Ramayana. Ramayana is not a new book. Ramayana is extremely old. Long ago, Bhojaraja calls the author of Ramayana, that is Valmiki, as the one who laid the path for all poets. Madhumaya Banitinam Margadarshi Maharshihi. This Maharshi Valmiki is called as Adikavi, not just by us. Long ago, Kalidasa calls Maharshi Valmiki as Adikavi in his Raghuvamsha Mahakavya, Kaver Adhyasya Shasanam. Even before Kalidasa, Vedavyasa calls Maharshi Valmiki as Adikavi in Mahabharata. Proktam Chaiva Adikavina. Vyasa quotes a verse from Valmiki's Ramayana and says, this shloka is by Adikavi in Drona Parva. From good old days, Valmiki is known as Adikavi. And Ramayana is older than Mahabharata and Tripitaka of Buddhism. This is how most of the researchers view. I also view in the same way. This great Adikavya, the first among Kavyas, that's the meaning of Adikavya. This Adikavya describes Ayodhya. It means, from literature point of view, Ayodhya is the oldest city of the world. Long ago, before Tripitaka, before Mahabharata means before 5000 years. Mahabharata describes Saraswati river's sites, pilgrim spots that are situated in Saraswati river, which were there before 3000 BCE. After that they became extinct due to a huge great drought. We all know this can be found through satellite investigation. This is enough to understand that Mahabharata belongs to the era of 3000 BCE. And definitely Ramayana is older than Mahabharata. Such a very old epic is talking about a city, that is Ayodhya. What does it talk? Kosalo nama muditaha spito janapado mahan divishtaha sarayutire prabhute dhanadhanyavan. Ayodhya nama nagari tatrasi loka visruta manuna manavendrena yapuri nirmita swayam. Kosalo nama buditaha. Maharshi Valmiki is talking about Kosala kingdom. Muditaha, the kingdom is always cheerful. Spitaha, it has lot of grains. Kosala is prosperous with grains. It's a great kingdom, Janapado Mahan, in the bank of river Sarayu. Prabhuta Dhanadhanyavan, this Kosala kingdom is wealthy. After telling this, Maharshi Valmiki says, the capital city of this Kosala kingdom is Ayodhya, which was built by Vaivaswata Manu. This is what recorded by Maharshi Valmiki. And Valmiki describes the city in a beautiful way. It has well-laid paths with huge apartments. Dhanakosha and Dhanyakosha is granary. It's wonderful. Roads are washed, kept clean with fragrant flowers, washed with sandal mixed water. Such great city it is. With very great mansions the city is decorated. It has various vidyashalas, vaidyashalas, chitrashalas, pakashalas and patashalas. Beautiful gardens with many blossoms. All these things are described by Valmiki. Ayodhya's civilization and Ayodhya's culture. Ayodhya has a very ideal structure with its highways, royal streets. The subjects of Ayodhya, people of Ayodhya are very happy. Tasmin puravare hrishtaha dharmatmanaha bahusrutaha narastushtaha dhanai swai swaihi aludhaha satyavadinaha. Always they are motivated, they have moral in their jobs. They are not greedy, they are truthful, always remain honest. Kami va na khadaryo va nrusamsaha purushak kvachit drashtum shakyam ayodhyayam na vidvan na cha nastikaha yaga. People are neither too much lusty and nor too much wrathful. Nobody is cruel in Ayodhya. people are gentle in general. They are soft speaking and they talk sweetly in a gentle way, having good manners. Na avidvan, nobody is a wicked, nobody is a stupid fellow in Ayodhya. Nacha nastikaha, na vidvan nacha nastikaha. Varne shagra chaturteshu devata atiti poochakaha ya. Kritagnyascha vadanyascha shuraha vikrama sanyutaha. They reveal hospitality to atithis who come to their city. A city's people's features are judged only by seeing how they treat the strangers. Here Valmiki says that atithi poojakaha, they honor their atithis in a very great sincere way. Kritagnyascha, people are men of gratitude. Shura vikrama samyutaha, they are very capable of doing the things. And they are well decorated. Nobody is there without earring. Na kundali, na makuti, na sradvi, na pi arupavan. Nobody is there without garland. Na amukuti, nobody is there without crown, without bearing crown. All are well educated. Na shatanga vitatrasit, na prato, na bhagusruta. All are well versed in Vedas and Shastras. City shines with all these great people. That's the beauty of the city. Such a kind of city is described in Adikavya, the first and foremost of all Kavyas. So, if Mohenjo-daro has to be preserved due to its oldness from archaeological point of view, it becomes our prime duty to preserve Ayodhya, which is extremely old in literary point of view. In literature point of view. And here Valmiki continues to describe the king who rules Ayodhya. King Dasharatha, great man. Tasyam puryam ayodhyayam vedavid satyasankaraha dirgadarshi mahatejaha paurajanapada priyahaya. The king Dasharatha ruled Ayodhya, who is visionary, who is luminous, who is lovable to all people in his kingdom. Vedavitu, who is a knower of Vedas, who is a man of truthfulness. Ikshvakunam atirataha yajva dharmarato vashi Maharishikalpo Rajarishihi Trishulokeshu Visrutahaya. He is a very great Kaur warrior in his Ikshvaku lineage. He performs various yajnas for the universal welfare. He is interested in Dharma, Dharma Rataha. He had restrained senses, Vashi. He is parallel to great Brahmarshis, Maharishikalpo Rajarishihi. Well known in all three worlds, Trishudokeshu Visrutaha. Balavan nihata mitraha, mitravan vijitendriyaha, dhanaischa sanchayihi cha anyaihi shakra vaishravanopama. He is equal to Indra and Kubera in his wealth. He has controlled his force. He has friends in all corners. Kavi is going on describing this king and his ministers in even. Ministers did not harm the people. Without harming them, they collected the tax. And they offer benefits to the people. They are highly objective while judging the things. These kinds of descriptions about ministers, suparikshitaha, they are well checked by the king. True well-wishers of the kingdom, the state, on the people, on the king. This is how these ministers are described. The king maintains democracy even in monarchy. When the king wants to coronate his son Rama, he talked to the people. That's democracy. He discusses with people. He's asking people, can I coronate? Though Rigveda has a hint of democracy, Vishastva Sarva Vanchantu, Bhaktad Rajya Madhiprachat. O king, may your rulership not fall, may your subjects love you. This is what Rigveda says. As a case study of this statement, the king Dasaratha, instead of deciding himself, he asks his own people, I feel that he is capable of ruling the kingdom, but how do you think? Because you people are madhyamikas. Amya madhyastha chintahi vimardabhyadiko vaya adikodaya. I will tell anything about my son because I love my son like anything. He is after all my son. But what do you feel about my son? That objective view is very important, the king Dasaratha says. On hearing this, subjects respond, Ichchamaha, we all wish Rama to be the ruler. We want Rama as our ruler. We want Rama as our ruler. We want Ramarajya. This is how people respond. Such a man he is. Then the king asks, why do you want him as your ruler? People are going on describing the tall virtues of Rama here. Those things are recorded by Maharshi Valmiki. The ideal man. Ayodhya is the ideal city of ideal mother of that ideal man. Ayodhya is seen as an example throughout the world. A role model city. For example, Thailand's old capital is named as Ayutthaya. Having Ayodhya as role model, they named their capital as Ayutthaya. Koreans call their predecessors as Ayodhyans. The name Ayodhya is everywhere there in India, pan-Indian name. In our Tamil Nadu, we have Ayodhi Pattinam. Very many names in Tamil Nadu. Ayodhi Dasa, Ayodhi Dasa Pandita, Ayodhi. These kinds of names are there throughout Tamil Nadu. Madurantakam of Tamil Nadu, Vadur of Tamil Nadu, they are called as Dakshina Ayodhya, Southern Ayodhyas. Why? Because we all see Ayodhya as our role model. Even Bhadrachalam in Andhra Pradesh is taken to be Southern Ayodhya by Andhra people. Everywhere this Ayodhya, Ayodhya, Ayodhya is there. We all look at Ayodhya with pride. The oldest city of India. And this Ayodhya, not only Ayodhya, whole Ramayana. Everywhere in Asia we see Ramayana. Ramayana is an Asian epic. In Indonesia, in Thailand, Ramayana is their culture. In so many other countries like Sri Lanka, we see Ramayana in China, Ramayana in Russia. And if you take India, in every language there are dozen Ramayanas, minimum. The most glorious literatures are Rama stories in Indian languages. For example, in Tamil, one of the most glorious literary works is Kambam. In Malayalam, Ezhuthachan's Adhyatma Ramayana, Kilippattu Ramayana. In Avadhi, in Hindi, the oldest, the most glorious literature is Ramchintamanas of Tulsidas. Madhava Gandhali's Ramayana is the oldest, the most glorious one in Assamese literature. Krithivas Ramayana, Rama Panchali, is one of the most glorious literary works in Bengali. Thus, Ramayana is pan-Indian, it's not just a pan-Indian. All we Indians take Ramayana, Rama and the characters of Ramayana as our role models. That's how our predecessors showed. There are few forces which unify us, the Indians. One of the most important forces that unifies India is Rama, Ramayana. Through Ramayana, we are well knit in India. We stand as one through Ramayana, Ramarajya. We stand as one through Ramabhakti. We all are Ramabhaktas. Rama unites us. Rama is a link of all of us in India. So, it becomes our prime duty to guard this great city, Ayodhya. Yodhum Narha Ayodhya. And this Ayodhya, which is now there, if Mohenjo-daro is a wonder, Ayodhya is wonder of wonders. It's because though Mohenjo-daro is extremely ancient, it is not a living city now. Now it has become just an archaeological site. But Ayodhya is a living city, living culture. Maharshi Valmiki described Ayodhya in Ramayana. Up to our times, this Ayodhya is existing. That too in the same name. Is it not a miracle? We can't take it easily for granted. We have to get amazed. In the same name that city is existing up to our times. Ayodhya, which we are seeing in front of us, is the same Ayodhya which Valmiki is describing in the epic. How do you know? See the geographical location. Maharshi Valmiki says Ayodhya is situated in the bank of Sarayu. Now the existing town in the name of Ayodhya also is located in Sarayu, Sarayu's bank. From Ayodhya, if we go to south, we can see the Prayagraj, Ganga Yamuna Sangama, Maharshi Bharadwaja's Ashrama. Valmiki also describes in the same way. In between Ganga Yamuna Sangama and Ayodhya, Valmiki mentions various rivers. The same rivers are flowing now also. This is the proof. What else is required? What else is required for Ayodhya? The same Ayodhya is existing now. That's why I called this as wonder of wonders. It's not a dead city. It is up to our time. It's a living city. People are habitating. Not only that, people dwell in the same culture which was described long ago by Valmiki. Same culture. Long ago, Valmiki describes that Ayodhya was filled with Vedic chants. Even now, Ayodhya has Vedic chanting. Many Vedic Gurukulas, Veda Patashalas, Ayodhya is filled with the resonance of the Vedas. The same Vedic culture is prevalent now also in Ayodhya. Rama Bhakti, which is described by Maharshi Valmiki in Ayodhya, the same Rama Bhakti, the stream of Rama Bhakti flows now also in the same Ayodhya. Yodhum Narha Ayodhya. So its etymological meaning becomes meaningful. Ayodhya means the town which cannot get conquered. Yodhum Narha Ayodhya. The word Ayodhya comes in Taittiriya Yajus. in Ajurveda. Ayodhya has another beautiful name, Saketa, that also comes in Taittiriya Ajurveda. Saketa means the town of knowledge. Kiti Sanyane is a dhatu, is a root from which Saketa comes. Ayodhya is a city of knowledge. Ayodhya is a city that cannot be conquered. That Ayodhya we are seeing in front now, and it gives immense delight to all of us that in that Ayodhya, in Rama Janmabhoomi, today we see Bhumi Puja happening. Rama Janmabhoomi is a life of all of us who practice Dharma. Rama Janmabhoomi represents humanity. Humanity incarnated in that particular spot. Whole world comes to know humanity, Dharma. This Dharma embodied, Dharma incarnated in that particular spot. Therefore, that spot has to be preserved. Sri Rama Janmabhoomi, Skanda. It is Skanda Purana which talks about various spots of Ayodhya, giving a detailed location. Today what they call GPS. GPS. It is like GPS. If you go to Skanda Purana, you can see that Skanda, the son of Lord Shiva, is giving the locations of the places in Ayodhya, various places, among which Rama Janmabhoomi is the most important one. Vigneshwarat purva bhage vasishtat uttare tatha lomashat paschime bhage janmasthanam iti smrutam. This is what Skanda Purana says. Vigneshwarat purva bhage, from the east of Vigneshwara temple. Even now the Vigneshwara temple exists. If you go to Ayodhya, you can see that. From the north of Vasishta Gurukula, Vasishta Uttare Tatha. From the Paschima Bhaga of Lomasha Maharshi's Ashrama, there is Rama Janmabhoomi. Yad Drishtva Garbhavasa Bhajjayo Bhavet. On seeing which, one gets liberated. This is what Skanda Purana says. Kapila Gosakasrani, thousands of cows can be offered by one in every day. And one goes and sees, has darshan of Rama Janmabhoomi. Both are equal, it is told in Skanda Purana. Such great Rama Janmabhoomi. And there this Bhumi Puja is happening today. It is a dream of very great sadhus. Selfless sadhus of India dreamt it. For a long time, very great souls dreamt it. Now in our time, it is becoming fruitful. We all are seeing this Janmabhoomi's Bhumi Puja. And Prime Minister of India is doing this puja with his own hands. And in this Janmabhoomi function, may we all chant more and more Ramanama. We all pray for universal welfare. We all pray for the growth of Ramarajya. What is Ramarajya? Valmiki describes. Sarvam mujitame vasit. Sarvo dharma paro bhavat ramamevanupashyantaha nabhyahimsan parasparam. All were happy in Ramarajya because all were practicing dharma. All were reflecting Rama. They did not harm each other. Napariya devan vidavaha नच व्याळकृतं भयं न व्याधिजं भयं वापी रामे राज्यं प्रशासति. विडोस डिड नॉट सफर इन रामराज्य. नो थ्रेट फ्रॉम वाइल्ड बीस इन रामराज्य. न व्याधिजं भयं वापी डिसीजेस डिड नॉट स्प्रेड इन रामराज्य. नित्यपुष्पाः नित्यफलाः तरवः स्कन्दविस्तृताः काले वर्षी च पर्जन्यः सुखस्पर्शश्च मारुतः. ट्रीज वर ग्रोन विथ ह्यूज ब्रांचेस एंड विथ फ्रैग्रेंट ब्लॉसम्स एंड फ्रूट्स. ड्यू टू द टॉल ट्रीज ग्रोथ काले वर्षी च पर्जन्यः पीपल गॉट सीजनल रेनिंग. Healthy wind was blowing. This is Ramarajya. Nobody was poor in Ramarajya. Nanartaha kanchidaspurshat. Nirdasyurabhavallokaha. Nanartaha kanchidaspurshat. Nachasma vriddhaha balanam pretakaryani kurvate. Society was devoid of theft. Nobody was suffering from poverty. Elders were not destined to perform funeral rites for the little ones. Asan varsha sahasrani tata putra sahasrinaha nidamaya yashokas charame rajyam prashasati. They had very huge families, joint families. Yet there were no quarrels. People were free of complexes. It happened because in every family the woman gave birth to Rama like, Bharata like, Lakshmana like children. Raghavena yatha mata Sumitra Lakshmanena cha Bharatena cha Kaikeyi jivaputraha tatha striyaha. In this auspicious occasion of Bhumi Puja, may we pray for growth of such a Ramarajya. Ayodhya, Rama Janmabhumi temple is going to come. With that, the whole culture has to grow. Ayodhya's vital, that is dharma, the aspiration of universal welfare has to grow based on Ayodhya. This is very, very important. We should see in such a way that from Ayodhya, the aspiration of universal welfare and the culture based on it has to come out, has to spread everywhere throughout the world. Universal peace, universal harmony has to blossom. For that we pray, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Jai Sitaram.
Raghava Hatsa Dharma Jago Adharma Rekhago. Raghava Hatsa Dharma Jago. Vigyani Lakshana Gyani Nirasuniya Vigyani Lakshana Raghava Sat Dharma.